Hi, Monica. Welcome back. It's been a couple sessions since we began to talk about you and depression, its effect on you. I'm wondering if we could continue to go a little deeper into something we started to do at the end of the second session, which is to reframe depression, as you remember, as an unwanted house guest that's just really overstayed its welcome. What would that be like for you?
Oh, that'd be great. Thanks.
Okay. All right. So let's try to look at this unwanted house guest, depression. What has it been getting you to do against your better judgment?
Well, lately I never leave the house unless I absolutely have to get mail or food, or I just stay inside with the shades drawn. You know, I don't, I watch TV all day long. I don't take care of the things I'm supposed to. Okay.
And looking kind of globally, how has living with this unwanted visitor, depression, impacted your life?
Lately it's been making me feel bad because I'm realizing that I'm getting behind on my bills. I'm not up on my the housework in my house like I used to be. I don't take care of myself as well as I used to be. You know, I just feel kind of hopeless. I don't have a lot to look forward to.
And yet, I think that I'm hearing, or I have heard, that there are some lies that this unwanted visitor, depression, has been telling you about yourself. What are those?
Well, it feels like, you know, depression has been telling me that my life is over since my husband's gone. You know, there's an anger that I get mad at myself because he's gone. I feel guilty that I didn't make him go to the doctor more. You know, it makes me feel like I can't change anything that's happened.
I see. I think there might be some value here, and you tell me how you think about looking at the impacts across your life of how this unwanted visitor, depression, who has just kind of glommed on to your life for now, to look at the effects. I wonder if you could tell me how depression has impacted different parts of your life.
Overall, I just want to stay out and keep everything away from me. You know, I don't call my friends like I used to. After my husband got sick, a lot of my friends moved away. I didn't make effort to make new friends. I used to like to go places, you know. I used to like to go to the museum. I stopped doing those kinds of things. I don't see my kids as much. We tend to argue more when we do interact. You know, I'm probably not the most fun to be around. I haven't gone back to work yet.
Wow, okay. And yet, this has been for a period of time, not forever. So I'm wondering, when did you first notice that depression was visiting you?
I'd have to say that depression started to visit me as it got close to my husband dying. You know, he had had cancer for 3 years, and I can remember beginning to feel sadness, beginning to feel like he wasn't going to make it, you know, feeling like that the end was coming near. You know, I spent a lot of time taking care of him. But when I began to realize that he was going to die, I would say that I began to feel depressed.
I see. But in this discussion and previously, I have a sense that you've already done some steps to encourage this unwanted visitor, depression, to leave. Could you tell me about those?
Definitely. You know, I've been kind of thinking about depression and thinking about the things I haven't done lately. It's coming to see you is a huge step for me to begin to address that. Just the fact I've been talking about it more. Mm-hmm. That's the biggest thing I've done.
Wow. Okay. Big steps. And I'm thinking that there are times when you have not allowed depression to influence you at all, Can you give me something about that?
Even when I began to feel depression when my husband got sick, you know, I often hid it from him. I didn't want him to see me sad or crying. I didn't want him to be worried about me while he's struggling to survive, you know? And so anytime I was taking care of him, I always tried to, you know, appear to be more pleasant than I was. I never wanted to see him to see me when I was upset, just because I didn't want it to complicate things for him more. So I was hiding it.
And I think we could see those times as hiding things, or we could see those times when you said no and you stopped depression from visiting you. Is that possible?
Yes, you know, I would say that I was able to control it when it came to him.
Wow. Okay. Let's try to take this apart piece by piece, this experience of depression overstaying its welcome. What do you see, or let's say if I was there with you, what would I see, or what would we see together when depression is going on and it's present?
Well, even though you didn't know me before, I see a person completely different than I used to be. You know, I feel hopeless, and I see a hopeless and kind of a sad person, you know, that's a little bit confused about where to go, what direction to take. I feel alone. You know, every decision I made in life, I made it with my husband, and I'm not quite sure how to move forward.
Let's see. And I think one of the things that we're doing here, and I'm beginning to hear hints of this, is we're building a vision of a time period when depression is gone. What would you look like then? What would you see then?
If depression was completely gone, you know, I would see the old Monica again. I would feel like the old Monica again. You know, I would be involved more with my family. I would be going out to art museums like I used to. I used to like to go to lecture series, you know. My house would be kept up, you know. I'd feel good about having, you know, company over, you know, versus being ashamed for someone to see how I'm living now. I would do more than just laying on the couch every day.
Right. And I think we've talked about this over the course of this prolonged visit of depression. There are times when depression isn't visiting you. What do we see then? What do you see? What would I see?
I would see a happier person, you know, a happier person that cares about their life, that is motivated to take care of things like I used to. You know, I would feel better about interacting with my friends and family versus feeling like a burden, feeling like, you know, feeling like I'm just going through the emotions, you know. I would feel present.
Okay. And alongside of some of what you experience and see when depression is present, what are the emotions there that you experience, especially that come up for you as we're discussing these, and then what would you experience in those periods?
Well, I feel, as I'm speaking about it now, you know, and even as I kind of distance myself from it, I still feel guilty, and I feel ashamed. You know, I feel ashamed that things have gotten to this point. You know, I feel guilty that I haven't been a very good, you know, maybe even a mother to my children, even though they're grown. You know, I haven't been the best friend like I used to be. I feel weak, you know, I feel not as strong inside. I don't have the same kind of hope, that hopelessness feeling.
And this has been a profound process of this unwanted guest depression being around you. What would you want your family or people who care about you, who are seeing some of this, but maybe they don't understand, what would you want them to know? What would you want them to understand about this unwanted guest depression and how it affects you?
I would want them to know that it's like, I realize this isn't the old me, you know, it's not like just them noticing it and me just thinking everything is fine. You know, I do realize that things have changed. Uh-huh. But I also want them to understand that, you know, that I want to get my life back on track. I'm not okay with what's been happening. I think sometimes they think that I've kind of just given up completely. But there is a large part of me that is trying to get my life back on track, and I want them to know that.
And in this work, I think we can see that there's going to come a time when you bar the door that you're going to say, depression can't control my life anymore or my emotions. What do you think that says about you and what you want for your life when that time is here?
Well, you know, I feel like that time is here now, that I'm in a position where I really want to have a better life, right? Okay. You know, I don't want to let this feeling be the rest of my life feeling. You know, I know that my husband wouldn't want me to be like this. You know, he would want me to try and, you know, move forward and to think about the person that I was before he died, and the person that my friends and family want me to be. You know, I want to be happy like I used to be. I want to learn to live again, you know, in a positive way. You know, how do I move forward without the love of my life? But I know that it's possible to find happiness and to not feel this level of sadness forever.
Well, thank you, Moya. Thank you, Monica, for this courage and looking at how you could reshape this story.